Congratulations, you made it to Genetic 6, the Universal Genetic Code Chart. In this video, we're going to talk about this chart, and the job of this chart is to take mRNA and convert it into the specific amino acid sequence that would be built into a protein. Really, this is the job of the ribosome and the tRNA, but we want to be able to do it on paper to figure out what code leads to what protein. Let's begin. Before we start talking about decoding the mRNA into the specific amino acid, I want to talk about amino acids themselves. I'm about to show you a chart of the amino acids. It's a little bit confusing, it's got a lot of information, but it's worth taking a look at. Here are the 20 standard amino acids. They all have different names, glycine, alanine, valine, and so on. And they all have a different shape. Don't get overwhelmed by all the chemical details that are shown here. Just know that each amino acid has a different shape. And when we get into biochemistry later, we will talk about how they're exactly built. Just know that they have a unique shape. They can be put in any order, and they can be reused. Each amino acid has a name, but sometimes we like to shorten that name. So we take the first three letters. So glycine, we like to shorten to GL. Y. Alanine, we like to shorten it to A-L-A, and I think you get the idea. Valine would be V-A-L, and so on. That's going to be important because when we look up these amino acids in the chart and figure out which one comes first, second, third, and so on, they're not going to be there. We're not going to see their full name. We're just going to see their abbreviation. Let's head down to the real chart, the Universal Genetic Code Chart. And here it is on the right, the Universal Genetic Code Chart. Universal because this works for any living thing. All living things have ribosomes and they all build proteins. We are going to figure out how to take DNA, go to mRNA, and then use mRNA in this chart to figure out which amino acids would be placed in the protein that is coded for. Let's start. All right, we have a string of DNA, and there are 9 bases. If I didn't have this labeled DNA right here, you'd still know it was DNA, because it contains a T. If it contained a U, it would be mRNA. One of the biggest mistakes my students make is they are given a DNA sequence. They try to use that in the Universal Genetic Code Chart. They can't find a T anywhere in here, and they give up, and they can't get the answer. So make sure that you know that this chart is for mRNA. When given DNA, you have to do an intermediate step before you can look it up in the chart. Let's do that. The first step is to make the mRNA. So we're just going to use the base pairing rule to figure out what the mRNA would be. T matches to A. A matches to U. C matches to G. And I'm just going to go ahead and go down the line. And there it is. We took our DNA and converted it into mRNA using the mRNA base pairing rule. Now we want to figure out the amino acids. I hope you remember from our protein synthesis video that mRNA is used in what are called codons or groups of three. So our next step is to break it up into groups of three. 1, 2, 3, break. 1, 2, 3, break. So we actually end up with 1, 2, 3 codons of 3 bases each. Now that we have the codons for mRNA, we can use the Universal Genetic Code Chart. Let's start with just 1 codon. There are 1, 2, 3 bases in the first codon AUG. That's going to code for one particular amino acid. But how do you do it? Let's take a look at the chart first. The first base will be found over here on the left. Then we will find the second base up here on the top. And then we'll use the third base over here on the right. And this is going to lead us to our answer, which amino acid would be placed there. Let's do it. Our first base, remember, in this codon was A. So I'll circle it. A is here. And that indicates that we are in this row of the chart. Okay, we haven't narrowed it down yet. The first letter just tells you the row. The second letter is U. So the second base up here is U. We have a choice, U, C, A, and G. So we're going to choose you, and that tells us we are in this column. So we've narrowed it down. We're in this row, we're in this column. That means we're in this box somewhere. And usually from this point, you can figure it out. We were looking for AUG. Here it is. But that last base, the third base over here on the right, will lead you right to the answer, because the last one in that box is G. So our mRNA, AUG, would be methionine, or shortened MET, or start. I'm going to put methionine. That is the start of most proteins. MET is the amino acid that would be placed there. I'm going to put a little peptide bond in there, and we're going to then move on to our next codon. I've made a mess of my chart, so I am going to erase my work, and I'm going to start with the next codon. Next codon is UUG. U is the first base. We'll find it on the left. U. The second base is also U. That means we are in the top left box. This row, this column, we're right here. And our last base was G. It's the last one in the column. UUG, that's the one we were looking for. It is leucine, or L-E-U. L-E-U is our amino acid. I shortened it to AA there. Put a peptide bond. I'm going to erase this so we don't get confused. And then I'm going to do the last one. G, well, the first base is G. It's down here. It's in that row. Second base is also G. That means here. So we're going to have to trace it down this column, this row. We are in this box right here. And you can find GGU. And remember, the U tells you the last letter over here on the right. Here it is, GGU. That is glycine, or GLY. This takes a little bit of practice. And remember the number one rule. This is for mRNA only. If you're given DNA, you must convert first using the base pairing rule. One of the interesting things is that we have 20 choices for amino acids. We have 20 amino acids. But when you think about it mathematically, for every codon, there are lots of choices. The first position, that number one position, is four choices, A, U, C, and G. So that's four choices. The second position has four choices, A, U, C, and G. You can repeat. The third position has four bases, A, U, C, and G. And to figure out how many permutations we have here, just multiply them together, and we get 64. There are 64 different codons that are possible using mRNA, but there are 20 different amino acids. So we have some redundancy, meaning that some of these codes are going to code for the same amino acid. Take a look at glycine. GGU, GGC, GGA, and GGG, all of them code for glycine. So there's some redundancy here. That is part of how the genetic code works. It's a little interesting fact about how this works. Hopefully, you understand that there are 20 different choices for amino acids. You use the universal genetic code chart to figure out which amino acid will be placed based on the mRNA code, not the DNA code. Well done.